Owning a Mini used to be a bit of a compromise due to its limited practicality, but the Countryman opens up the brand to a whole new audience. Because while it unquestionably looks like a Mini, the fact that it's got a bigger body and some rather useful rear doors means that you no longer have to be a contortionist to get into the back. And once inside, there's even enough room for adults. Look, headroom's pretty decent, and you can recline the rear seats, which is handy. You can even move them forward for more boot space, or backwards for more leg room. The Countryman is pretty spacious here in the front too. Doesn't matter if you're tall, because there's so much adjustment in the driving position, yet it still has that definite Mini feel to it. For instance, you've got that big central speedo, these toggle switches, and everything of course feels really well built. As for standard equipment, it's generous right across the range. All cars get air conditioning, Bluetooth for your mobile phone, 6 airbags, and DSC anti-skid control. Minis are supposed to be fun to drive, and the Countryman is no exception. Obviously, being slightly larger than the normal three-door hatchback, it isn't quite so go-kart-like or as darty, but it still has that kind of Mini trait of being responsive and agile through the corners. And of course, because you've got that jacked up suspension and the higher ride height, you get a better view over traffic, which means it's actually easier to drive in town.
It also means the Countryman can deal with more than just tarmac, especially if you go for the all-wheel drive version. Just don't expect it to do much more extreme off-roading than this.
But while it may be more capable than your normal Mini, the Countryman still has some of the same problems. For instance, the ride is pretty harsh and it kind of jiggles about a bit over rough surfaces. Also, at higher speeds, you get quite a bit of noise entering the cabin, and as a result, for longer journeys, it's not quite as comfortable as your more traditional family hatchbacks. As for other problems, well, some of the materials feel cheap, the switches are fiddly, the cup holders are small, and so are the side door bins, and you've got to be careful when selecting first because you can accidentally go into reverse.
Also, while the boot is a reasonable 350 litres, it's an awkward shape, and when you fold the rear seats down, there's a massive lip, although you can get a false boot floor as a cost option.
Finally, there's the looks, because for me, the Mini's quirky styling looks a little bit silly on the larger five-door body. That said, the Countryman does stand out, and it will hold its value better than its more mainstream conservative rivals. It's also pretty cheap to run as well, and if you go for Mini's excellent TLC package, it's cheap to maintain too.